As the whistle blew, the country collectively held its breath. We need this win.
But if ever the Matildas can stand up and rise to the occasion, tonight's the night.
The 27,000-strong crowd on the edge of their seats. Matildas have possession, barely 10 minutes in, and...
breaks kindly, Hayley Russell! What a moment for Australia! That's it. It won't count.
Heart in throat. VAR...
There is no offside decision!
Hayley Russell secures her first World Cup goal. Then...
ball's here, and it's a goal for Hayley Russell. Russell at the double in the first half.
We enter half-time with confidence levels at 7. But Mary Fowler knocks that to a strong 9.
And it's in.
The Canadians feeling the pressure. Russell at the receiving end of some rough play.
Hayley Russell.
On the angle.
They struggle to score it. In the final minutes of stoppage time, our captain, Steph Catley, steps up for the penalty and...
she puts the cherry on the cake.
Australia keeps the dream alive!
And there it is.
The Matildas screaming into the round of 16 with a 4-0 win, finishing the top of our group after Nigeria's nil-all draw with Ireland. And they did it, keeping Sam Kerr in the holster. The captain telling the team to win without her.
That says a lot about the belief in this team as well.
We're getting that public holiday, aren't we, Albo?
I reckon the states and territory leaders will be under enormous pressure.
Well, what are you going to do with your day off?
The only thing appropriate? Admiring powerful women. What are you going to do?
I don't know, I was just going to relax, but if you want to spend a day admiring me...
There's no denying the Matildas have booted Australia's love of football to the next level, and we're ready to back it till the end.
This now is going to be something incredible on Monday night.
Next week, the Matildas will face the runner-up from Group D. Could be China, Denmark or England. And we know they're all rubbish.
L-B-L-T, we've done it!
Former Matilda Tal Karp was there last night. She joins us now.
This is locked in. Obviously, we're going to win the World Cup now, right?
Clearly. That's Thank what God. Happened in my dream last night. I don't know what you were dreaming about, but we were holding that trophy. We were ready for statues.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
After that showing, we can do anything.
Incredible.
Hey?
And this was do or die for the Matildas last night, right? They were up against the Olympic gold medalists in Canada. Did anyone really see this coming?
Look, quietly confident that we would win. Did we think we were going to have the biggest win in the history of the Matildas? A resounding 4-0.
Yeah.
The idea of 4-0 against the Olympic champions when it was a do-or-die moment, that was spectacular. Biggest moment.
Yeah.
And great that Sam Kerr didn't play. So she was on the bench, but we didn't need her because we were in front early and were able to hold on to her effectively. She's recovering from injury. How much difference do you reckon that might make later in the tournament, that rest?
Oh, look, every day when you're recovering matters. She's got 7 days to recover. Yeah. But also, haven't the Matildas demonstrated that it's not a one-person team?
Yeah.
Yes.
There are a whole field of people that can put that ball in that net. 4 goals by our beautiful team.
Yeah.
We've got diversity there. We've also got unpredictability. So now the teams are even more worried and we've got Sam ready and raring for the next game, hopefully.
Well, speaking of recovery, I'm getting the sense you enjoyed last night and you might need another week to recover. Is that,
oh, my
is
God,
that
still wide while it's wide.
But they've got to turn it around. So they couldn't go wild.
No, they need to calm down. And do you know what they're doing right now? They're going back to home base in Brisbane. Individualised pillows, photos of the family on the wall, a recovery room that has a corner where they get to be creative. Okay. It has a table tennis table and it has a live-in barista. Now, tell me that that doesn't get you absolutely ready for your next game.
I mean, I want to play for the Matildas. That sounds unbelievable.
You know, you were talking about, you know, the significance of what they've done so far, but in my household it occurred to me last night that they've done something even more significant for the nation, which is I've got 3 teenage boys and a teenage daughter. My teenage boys love sport. They predominantly love men's sport. Last night, they were watching that game because it was a great, great sporting event. They were yelling so loudly that I was in the other room. I thought there was a home invasion. I came in and they were just over the moon. And I went, this is a really... it gave me goosebumps because it was really significant for women as sports people.
That makes me so happy to hear that. You know, 20 years ago, I played in my World Cup. I know I don't look a day older than... Yeah, anyway. And you know what? We had amazing people coming to watch us, but they were the tried and tested. They were the usual fans. Now what we've seen is not just little boys wearing kerseys, mm-hmm. little Sam Kerr jerseys mm-hmm. and Kat Lee shirts and everything else, but teenage boys, adult men going nuts. Yes. We saw that on the screen just a second ago. And what does that say about where we've come, who we are heroing? And you know what? What happens on the football field does not stay on the football field. What is that going to mean for That's workplaces true. And for homes?
And they're makes standing so on the shoulders of giants, mm-hmm. you know?
I am pretty short. We had a joke about my name a little bit
That's
earlier.
That's they've got to stand on your shoulders.
But they are selling Tal Karp jerseys in the alley out the back. Good luck. We're out of time, I'm afraid. We'd love to keep celebrating, but I guess we've got to do some news and stuff. Would you please thank Tal Karp? Yeah.